Hi, myself, I'm Ratna Bhushan. Welcome to the program, The Great Bharat and the Great People. My friends, I'm going to share you one of the beautiful article published in Hindu newspaper. The most preferred party of young India, the most preferred party of India. Good evening, Honorable Prime Minister Ji. This is the program for you and for the people of our nation. It will cover your poor efforts for the betterment of the nation and suggestion for you, so that we can make this country more glorious in the whole world. So this program is dedicated to young India. The program is dedicated to the young generation of India. The most preferred party of young India. This article was written in Hindu newspaper by Amrit Negi and Jyoti Mishra. Among the youth except in non-Hindu communities, the BJP has found acceptance across the caste groups. PM Modi's popularity was a great pull factor. Since 2014, India has been noted that young voters are particularly a strong supporter of Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP. The party has taken care to assiduously woo this segment. It initiated several campaign programs to attract the youth before 2019 Lok Sabha election. A digital campaign, Youth with Modi, Youth with Modi, Youth with Modi, was launched on social media to connect people on a single platform to discuss and advertise the popular political introduced by National Democratic Alliance NDA. Government, the youth wing of the BJP Bharatiya Janata Party Yuva Morcha launched a campaign called Modi Yuva Shakti, Modi Yuva Shakti, Modi Yuva Shakti. This was used to popularize the BJP schemes among college students. Prime Minister Narendra Modi started focusing on youth much before the election and urged them to get registered as voters. For instance, on 15th August 2017, in his Independence Day speech, Mr. Modi said 2018 would be an important year as all those who were born at the start of the century would turn 18 and should get registered as voters. They are going to be the creators of the destiny of our nation in 21st century. I heartily welcome all these youth, honor them and offer my respect to them, he said. In other words, the BJP was keenly aware of the importance of the youth vote. A successful strategy. The party's strategy worked. Data from the post-war study conducted with Lok Niti confirmed that BJP emerged as the most preferred party among the first time among young voters. In the 18 to 20 age, 41% voted. 41% voted for the BJP in this election, which is a 4 percentage points higher than the party's national vote share. The BJP vote share increased by 4 percentage points among first-time young voters from 2014. However, this was comparatively lower than the party's gain from voters of other age groups. The party's vote share among those in the 23 to 27 age bracket was 8 percentage points higher than what it was in 2014. Interestingly, the Congress vote share among 18 to 22 years old was 3 percentage points higher than 2014. The support for the BJP also increased among young women voters. It is true that there is no great difference between youth vote for the BJP and what the party receives from the voters of other age groups. But the Congress relative inability to garner votes from second-time voters, 23 to 27. And also from these 28 to 35 age bracket gave BJP a considerable advantage. It is possible that having voted the BJP for two or three elections, these young voters may continue voting for the party in future elections, thus giving the BJP a long-term advantage. Busting some myths. This advantage can be seen across caste groups. The BJP, traditionally labeled as a party of Hindu upper caste, now has acceptance among the younger voters belonging to other castes too. Among the low OBC, for instance, it saw a 14 percentage point increase in the support among the youth from the last election. Nevertheless, a skew is still visible as young voters among the upper OBC and Dalits have not supported the party in such large numbers. Similarly, the BJP could not find acceptance among young voters from non-Hindu communities, so its appeal among the youth remains limited to youth, Hindu youth in particular. It is noteworthy that the BJP acceptability saw a dip of 11% points among youth from other religious minorities. Another myth which was busted in this election was that BJP is an urban party. In this election, its vote share was higher among young voters in its town and rural India in the cities. Prime Minister Narendra Modi was a pull factor for the first time voters from the party or the local candidate. For these voters, for the prime ministerial candidate was the most important consideration while voting. 1/3 of the young BJP voters saw the prime ministerial candidate as the most important consideration while voting. This was nearly double the national average. This can also be affirmed by the fact that the same proportion, 33% of the young BJP voters asserted that they would have BJP voters, Mr. Modi had not been prime ministerial candidate. This figure was 10 percentage points higher than the national average. In states such as Haryana, Rajasthan, Uttarakhand, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Mr. Modi's popularity among the youth was higher than the state average. Interestingly, in two southern states which have strong state-based parties, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, Mr. Modi was the most preferred prime minister among the youth. The Balakot air strike also gave a push to the BJP's campaign as shown in the table. It should not be wrong to say this incident changed the discourse of election and pushed issues like unemployment, price rise, agrarian distress to the background. This can be ascertained by the fact that young voters who consider joblessness as an issue voted by the BJP after hearing about their air strike. In this election, the youth was clearly with Modi. आपको दिखा सकता हूँ मैं. I can show you the percentile among the youth. Upper caste, youth from OBC, youth from lower OBC, Dalit youth, Adivasi youth, and you can see the percentile. So this is one of the fine article published in the Hindu newspaper. Congratulations to Honorable Prime Minister Ji. And we have a great faith on you. We have a great belief in you. We have great faith on your hard work. And we believe that you will make this country more and more prosperous and glorious. Thank you, sir.